Hello, and welcome to Hello. Today we are going to be in combat with one of the human psyche's less interesting cousins. It can strike anyone at any time and be bloody annoying to pretty much everybody around. It is
apathy.
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 Apathy. Hello. I just received this letter this morning from a Mr. of It reads, I wonder if you can help. Having been an active, virile sort of person all my life, I have recently found myself consumed with an increasing sense of listless inertia. All my usual pursuits have ceased to hold any joy for me. I couldn't even be bothered to get dressed this morning. As a result, I write this naked. I have even just noticed that the garden shed is on fire, but I can't be bothered. Now I'm no expert, but it didn't take me long to work out that what Mr. was suffering from was apathy. Apathy. Apathy.
Apathy.
Apathy!
That's right. Today we are in combat with apathy, a serious condition of the human spirit that roughly 157% of the UK population is suffering from at any given time. Call it lethargy, falling into the chasm of meaninglessness, torpor, sucking on the armpit of death, or just an overwhelming desire to do sod all. Apathy can look like anything from this to this. You might be thinking, but does this even matter? I mean, really, who gives a toss? Think what you like. It may surprise you to learn that apathy is, in fact, a serious problem. Left unchecked, the damage apathy can do to human productivity could be greater than you think.
Consider the following as just a few examples. The Industrial Revolution. The French Revolution. Prince. And the Revolution. None of these would have been possible had apathy been.
Many inventions would not have been invented. The cheese grater,
the bicycle,
the Death Star, the skip, the Satsuma as an international commodity, not to mention several glittering careers. Charlotte Rampling, Barry Manilow, Karen Halibut, Gary Caribou, Lenny Bannister. So we've established just how devastating apathy can be. But what, if anything, can you do about it?
I recall a time when I was apathetic. I could find no pleasure in or commit to anything. All my usual pursuits appeared as dry dust to me. And then, one day, something changed. I was reluctantly engaged in some necessary task, which I somehow, through extreme personal skill, succeeded in, despite the seeming hopelessness of my apathetic existence. It suddenly occurred to me, I had just successfully solved a problem. From then on, I decided to perceive everything as a problem to be solved. I even decided to treat my apathy as a problem to be solved, and engaged in a range of symbolic acts to prove to myself and the world that I had conquered and exploded apathy from my life forever.
Custard.